get you updated on what's happened in the second round so far, Bob.
Well, to start things off, Ottawa took Radim Bekanic, a Czech defenseman. San Jose followed that up. Sean Donovan, a forward from the Ottawa 67s. The first goaltender taken after Jocelyn Thibault by the Tampa Bay Lightning, Tyler Moss from Kingston. And then the Anaheim Mighty Ducks took Nikolai Zuligin, a defenseman from Russia. Another goaltender goes to the Winnipeg Jets. And a traded pick, Scott Lanko from the Portland Winterhawks. The New Jersey Devils follow up by taking Jay Pandolfo from Boston University. Edmonton Oilers picked up David Vaborny from Czech Republic. New York Rangers pick up Regina defenseman Lee Sorkin. And the Dallas Stars take Jamie Langenbrunner, player from Minnesota High School. Jani Niinimaa, defenseman from Finland, goes to the Philadelphia Flyers. And Maxim Betts, the scoring star for the Spokane Chiefs, a Russian-born player, goes to the St. Louis Blues, followed by another Russian, Denis Taguroff from Togliatti. He's gone to the Buffalo Sabres, followed by number 39, Brendan Morrison, to the New Jersey Devils. Now here's our Gary Green with Serge Savard.
Serge, the Montreal Canadiens have always been very successful in the second round.
Well, yes, we've been some. We had a lot of locks in the second round. We made a lot of trades for early second pick. And when you go into the second round, there's always a lot of players that are rated in the first round that are still available. And we had a lot of luck. So if you look over the first round, we're with most of the team, our rate of success is about 30%. That's about what it is.
Serge, you've always had a good-sized scouting staff, and it seems to have paid off for you. Do you see some teams that are going with far fewer scouts? Your plans for the future?
Yeah, well, you don't need that many scouts. If you want to, with central scouting, we got a pretty good central scouting system. But this team, we always want to build by the base, from the base, and we produce our own players if we can. And I think we have more depth that way, and by trading so many players for draft choices, so we produce more players.
Do you still see in the future your team sticking with a farm system? A lot of the teams are starting to share teams, and some are going away from the mamas. What do you see in the future?
We're not going to share teams. We're spending anywhere from $700,000 to $1 million with our farm club every year, and that's the cost that we agreed to pay to develop players. We're not going to save half $1 million to maybe miss four or five players.
Thank you very much, Serge. I hope I didn't jinx you today. I hope you have a good second round as well. And
but if you keep talking to me, I might miss a second round.
All right, we better let Serge go. Back to you guys.
Well, the Montreal Canadiens have indeed had some terrific second rounds in NHL drafts past.
Hey, would they be the Stanley Cup champions if not for John LeClair, a second rounder?
And as a look at the Montreal Canadiens, it is a team that is deep in history, of course, but they have really done very well.
Well, they certainly have, and Serge Savard hit the nail on the head when you're talking about the second round. Quite often there are a lot of good first-round prospects for one reason or another that have slipped to the second round. They're still very good prospects, and at that point, but maybe a little less heralded than some of the other guys. And as a result, they grow up with less expectation, less attention on them. They're allowed to develop, and quite often they turn out to be quite almost like a gem.
So as the second round continues here at the Colisée, if you're looking for one surprise that happened to us here today, have you spotted anything that really shocked you so far, Bob?
Well, the Buffalo Sabres at pick number 38 took a guy by the name of Denis Taguroff, and there's really not a lot known about this guy other than the fact he's a Russian player, and that's not unusual that a Russian's taken at that spot, but he's not one of the higher-profile Russians, not one of the higher-profile Europeans, so that would qualify as a bit of a surprise. A very early run on goaltenders, Tyler Moss, Scott Lankow, all going early in the second round.
Well, hockey dreams continue to be made here at the Colisée in Quebec City as the 1993 NHL entry draft continues, and we'll be right back with more in just a moment.